I get bored really easy. I just always need action in my life. And that's why I love motorsports so much. It just get me that satisfaction of getting that adrenaline. I think I'm just unstoppable. I just want to keep pushing every day and every day just to be a better person. And what's really scared me is when the doctors say that you're not gonna come back from it 100%. When you get older, you might need a fake knee. That's when I really like, whoa, okay, it's real. With all the surgery I had with the doctor, everything he told me, and seeing how bad my knee was, I think I just did not want to sacrifice my body more than it was, because it was really reflecting in my whole life. Just going bicycle with my family or just going hiking with my friend, it was impacting everything. And that's where I was like, you know what, it's my biggest passion, but I want to keep pushing and I want to do other stuff, so let's just turn the page and do a new adventure. You want me to sign it?
Yeah.
Here you go.
You're one of my favorite dogs.
Yeah, thank you. Were you here last year?
2 years ago.
Nice.
This is Cynthia Gauthier, and her new adventure has led her here.
Here you go. You want to take a picture?
Yeah.
Let's do it.
We were wondering for a selfie.
Yeah, let's do it.
She is a Monster Jam athlete.
Yay!
What
do you tell her?
Thanks.
Yeah, thank you.
The French Canadian's passion for motorsports began as a family affair.
My dad always bring me to all kind of racing. That was NASCAR, we went to Daytona. He bring me to a lot of motocross race. We went to Unadilla. I was just a little girl on the side of the track, just looking at all the racer. And in my head, I was like, one day I want to be one of them.
That day arrived when Cynthia purchased her first dirt bike at the age of 18.
The first year I had my dirt bike, I just right away went to racing. I was just addicted to it. I did not care about the boys. I did not care about drinking, going to bar. All I was thinking is go riding the next morning and keep riding. And just hour and hour burning fuel. That's all I wanted. I was just so passionate about it. It was just like, I felt like I was in my own world when I was on my dirt bike, and I was just so happy.
How old were you when you decided to walk away from motocross?
I was, I would say, 5 years ago. So, 25. Okay. Yeah.
A full knee and shoulder reconstruction forced Cynthia to walk away from racing motocross forever. But before that happened, she had discovered something that would help her in ways she had never imagined.
When the doctor told me I have to be really careful, my knee is not gonna be back to where it was before, I was pretty bummed. He told me, you know, no more jump bucks, no more running, no more, like, it was crazy, the list he gave me. And I was just like, damn, I really have to stop doing everything.
Go up on the tippy toes. All the way, arching, and then hit the position. Good. Do that 5 times. So we're feeling, what we're doing mentally when we're on our tippy toes is feeling the position that we're in, and then hit the position. Yeah, good.
They did modify some workout for me and make sure like I was not like hurting or anything. I think it made my recovery way faster. I actually like had no pain now. Like the doctor cannot believe how much I'm healthy, how much like all my surgery are healing so good, and I think it's all about because of CrossFit.
There we go. Oh, that was awesome. Yes, There you go.
My body's been the best shape it ever been. I was not as strong before my surgery. I'm actually more healthy than I was before any surgery.
There's a saying in the motocross world, with age comes the cage. Meaning that when your body can no longer take the abuse, you switch to a form of racing that is less likely to get you injured. For Cynthia, that meant a switch to off-road racing.
For me, I was like, wow, I can almost do motocross, but safer with a cage around me. And it was like giving me back the adrenaline I needed. So I did that for 2 years, was in love with it. But in the same time, that's where I met the people in the Monster Jam industry and just a new adventure started. It's definitely one of the biggest racing vehicle you could race. Those truck goes to around like 1500 horsepower. They're really powerful, but they're pretty heavy. They're around 12,000 pounds. So a pretty heavy vehicle, but pretty fast.
As part of the Monster Jam Triple Threat Tour, Cynthia actually races three different vehicles.
The ATV, the Monster Jam Speedster, and the Monster Jam truck. So it's really demanding, way more physically than just driving the truck. When they asked me to do this tour was, oh my God, like I quit racing dirt bike and now I'm coming back to a Monster Jam ATV. But I was like, you know what? I'll take that challenge. It's action, it's nonstop. Like from the beginning of the show to the end of the show, there's action and it's just nonstop. That's what the challenge is. Like you go on your Monster Jam truck and right away you gotta run, get changed for your ATV and get back on the ATV, go change, go back on the Monster Jam truck. You go on your Speedster, so there's a lot of action, but it's fun. I love it.
Cynthia's passion for her sport doesn't overshadow her roots. She keeps a good luck charm in her truck to remind her where she comes from.
My mom, before I left, she gave me that little moose, that little Canadian moose, and she just said, you know what, I know you have a great future, and I just want you to remember where you come from, and I want this little thing to just travel with you and stuff. So it's just been in my truck for like 4 years now, and it's traveled all around the world. I went to Brazil, France, Spain, Chile, Mexico, Canada. So it's big, like it's a big sport. We have fans, the Monster Jam fans are all around the world. So it's an amazing industry.
And with over 14,000 CrossFit gyms worldwide, Cynthia has no problem finding a place to work out.
I travel a lot. It's hard for me to be with my friend and stuff, but every CrossFit I go, I make friends. Like, I feel like it's just a big international family. Yeah! I mean, I can go in Spain, drop in a CrossFit, and people are so nice to me, they welcome me, and it's just a big family. I always have so much fun, even if I have no idea what they're explaining. We find a way to understand each other, they find a way to correct me, they'll show me just with sign and movement. We don't need the language. I mean, the passion is there. We're just loving the same thing. And I think that's show why CrossFit is so international.
As a female competing in what traditionally has been a man's world, Cynthia quickly discovered that her actions have inspired others.
In my mind, I was like, if I can impact one person to be positive and to give them the best advice, wow, that's huge. That's like better than a paycheck.
Hey girl, how are you? Good, you excited? Yeah?
Yeah, I love it, beautiful.
Thank you. Hey, it's girl power today. Girls are winning.
I try to work really hard to be the best example, to be the best role model. If I had kids, what would I want them to look at? So that's how I see it. I don't know, it's amazing feeling when somebody tell you, hey, like, you inspire me so much. Like, I look up to you, and one day I want to be a Monster Jam driver. And I feel like every year we get more women in the industry. We have way more little girl come to the show. It's not just a guy thing. There's a lot of girls come to the show, and when they see girl winning, it's just a girl power thing. They just really support each other, and for me, it means the world.
Do you hear that boom from a mile away? Like a big Greek god with a lightning blade. Do you smell that smoke through the dirty rain? Gonna burn this town like a 10-ton train. Clap your hands together, stomp your feet on this floor. We're gonna rise up like an army, take this world by storm. Clap your hands together, stomp your feet on this floor. We're gonna rise.